Good evening, everybody. So once again, I've come back to give some explanation about aluminium products. You know, in I think in my previous video, I said that the roof that I invoke nowadays, they are the aluminium products and the stone coated product. Those are the two roofing sheets that last long. Those are the two roofing sheets that you can remove and reinstall again. The other one, you can't try that. And the other ones don't have much guarantee. They don't have too much water resistance. They don't have fire resistance. So, aluminium and stone coated, you can remove them and reinstall it again. You know, aluminium, you know, the characteristic of aluminium is that they have lighter weight, they have resistance to corrosion, and they are stable to weather degradation. They are stable to heat, they are stable. So, meaning that a pure aluminium will remain in its state for a very longer time, for ages. Like if you use an aluminium, you will leave it, your son will inherit the aluminium without replacing. The son of your son will inherit it up to like 6th generation will inherit it, because nothing will happen to it. You know, even our normal zinc still lasts very long. Let's now talk about aluminium, because aluminium is zinc corroded as time goes on, but aluminium is stable to corrosion, doesn't corrode. So those are the two, either the stone coated product and the aluminium product. That is the two products people are using now in Nigeria that fits the modern house, and they are durable and they are good to use. They are also beautiful. So if you build a house, if you don't have, because stone coated, the price of stone coated are a little bit higher compared to that of aluminium. If you don't have money for stone coated, you will go for aluminium products. So for everybody that is watching my video, please, because a lot of people still make the same mistake doing bad woodwork. A lot of people still make mistake doing bad woodwork. Upon all my explanation, all the video I've done about bad woodwork, we still have measurement that we just did recently that are still bad woodwork. Upon how those people are our follower on YouTube. So the only thing that I experience is that everybody is trying to run away from money. They try to give their job to a carpenter that give them the lesser quotation, which they didn't even ask question. Why is your quotation high? Why? What is the poline spacing you are using? What height are you using for this my house? What poline spacing you are using? So later now, when you come to measure it, they'll be telling you that I want to use Metcopo, and the woodwork they did for him is a woodwork. So long span, go for it. And this long span have 0.45. You can use 0.45 thickness. You can use 0.55 thickness. So the thickness also have an advantage on the roofing. The more thicker it is, the more beautiful your roof will be. Like this one now, you can see it's very, very neat because it's 0.55 and it's a normal aluminium. You will see some installation of roof that will be very rough. So if you check it, it may be two things that make it to be rough. Three disadvantages that make it to be rough. One, the installer did not handle it very well. The person that installed it does not install it very well. Two, the woodwork is bad. The poline spacing are not close to each other. Three, the aluminium may be. So when the poline spacing are not close and you now use 0.45 aluminium on it, it will be rough. So those are the three things that make aluminum to be rough. So when you use 0.45 aluminum and you use 0.55 aluminum, there is difference in the appearance, in the physical appearance, there is difference. So in the property also, there is difference. So when rain is beating 0.45, the sound it will bring in is different from when rain is beating 0.55. So meaning that 0.55 is more thicker than 0.45. So when you use 0.55, when you use 0.55, it come out very beautiful compared to 0.45. So if you want your 0.45 to be very, very beautiful, you know, normally a carpenter in Nigeria, in Lagos, in Nigeria, if carpenter want to do a woodwork of a long span, they do this. Some people do the polar spacing 900, some people do it 700, some people do it 800. It depends on how the person want to minimize his cost. So you can do it 900, 700, 800. In fact, some people do it 600, some people do it even 580. So the closer your woodwork, the closer the polar spacing, the more wood you buy and the more beautiful your roof will be. So meaning that if you want to use 0.45 long span, now you have to do your polar spacing to be what, to be very, very close to each other, so that the roof will come out neat, it will not be rough, so that when you see your house, you say, ah, they didn't install this thing very well. So your woodwork have to be very close when you want to use 0.45. but if you are using 5.5, in fact, your woodwork can be, the distance can be 800 millimeter, it will come out very beautiful because 0.55. but if you use 0.45 for a woodwork that is like 800 millimeter, it will not come out very neat, it will be rough. Everybody will know that you are using lesser thickness, 0.55. but it's not that the 0.45 will spoil or will damage after some year, but physically there is different, chemically there is difference, and feelingly there is difference between 0.45 and 0.55. so if you don't have money for 0.45, you go for 0.55, you go for 0.45. but the best aluminium to use is 0.55. so the best aluminium to be used is 0.55 aluminium for any forms of any commercial house or private house you are using. So the second aluminium product we'll be going to see now is step ties. This is an example of a black step ties. So step tie, you can see this one now, very long from this edge to this place. So this one now is almost like 4 meters. So this is a 4 meter long aluminium step tie. So the machine produces it out. So it's going to be put on a woodwork that is 4 meter from up to down. You just nail it straight. So this is an example of a step size. So step size select woodwork. So if you want to do woodwork for step ties, you must make sure the woodwork is a little bit high, and the pole line spacing are very, very closer. So because of, you know, if you want step ties to be very, very good and come out beautiful, you must nail it from this point. So all this joining, the woodwork should not be exceeding 3 joining, meaning there should be wood here, so the distance should not be much. So there can be wood here and another wood here, more perfect. So there can be wood here, still good. But the closer the wood, the more beautiful and the solid it will look, the more beautiful it will come out. So let me show you an example of a woodwork now. So look at this woodwork now. This is a long span. You can see this long span now. You can see the polar spacing. You can see the distance from this polar spacing and this. You can see it very wide. So a person that is not experienced now, we want to install step ties on this roof. It's not that it will not go. If you install it, you need it to work, or just go. You will see when rain fall, all your house will be leaking, and the appearance, it will not come out very beautiful. You can see this is long span, it fits long span, it look beautiful on a long span, but if it is step ties, you just see some place will swell up, some place will go inside, all this place will be bent, there will be some galloping here. You can see, and step ties is very, very prone to leakage if the woodwork is not well done. So let's check an example of a woodwork for step ties. Now, this is a typical woodwork with a step tie. You can see the polyline spacing very close. It's not, you can see the polyline spacing from this place to this place is very close. So this is an example of a woodwork that step ties like. A woodwork with little or no design, so that the rain will flow easily. So this is a woodwork of a step tie, a moderate height woodwork without no design, and the polyline spacing should be very, very closer. So this is an example of a typical woodwork that suits step ties. So I'll be showing you another. So this is another woodwork for a step ties. This is a woodwork, this one have parapet. You can see the woodwork are very close. You can see woodwork. So when the step ties was installed, look when it was installed, look at the step ties. So meaning that a woodwork with a step ties must be very, very close to each other. So this is an example. I think I told you about this house. So the owner of this house wanted to use step ties then. It's actually, he has received two quotations of his step ties, but nobody is telling him. Meaning that one, the woodwork is not too high, it's very short, and the distance, you can see the distance, very, very wide. So, and they want to use step ties here. So, ideally, I advise him to use long span, and use long span 0.55. So, this is the finishing of the house. You can see it now, very smooth and very good. So, this one will last forever without any maintenance. So this is step tie. No, sorry, no, this is multiple, not step ties. So we are still discussing about step ties. So this is another, this you can see, these are the woodwork, these are the types, these are the design, these are the woodwork, a woodwork without no design that water will just flow easily. These are the woodwork that step ties like, just flowing easily. So this is an example of step tie. These step ties come in different color. You can have red color, you can have blue color. This is a red color step ties. I think this house was done in the Ikorodu. So this is, you can see, this is a design of gutter. Inside the air, there's an aluminium inside the gutter. So where two roof meet. So this is a red step ties that was done in the Ikorodu by us. So, and this is 0.55 step ties. So, if you want to, meaning that if you want to go for step ties, you must make sure the woodwork are closed. This is another step ties that is done in Ifo. This is step ties. This is another step ties. This is another step ties. So step ties, when you want to use step ties, you must make sure the woodwork are not far away. The polyline spacing are very close. So the next roofing sheet we'll be talking about now is the Metcopo. Metcopo is half puffy appearance. It just like look like Milano for a stone coated. So this is an example of a green Milano. So this is a machine that is producing. All of them are long. It's not short. They are long. You can produce as long as it is. So this is an example of green Metcopo. So this is a green Metcopo. So this Metcopo don't like a woodwork that have design. And if you want to use Metcopo, you make sure your woodwork are straight. The pole line, the wood that you are going to use for the pole line, they are very, very straight. And the distance, the polyline spacing are very close. You can see all these cuffs like this, all these cuffs we are seeing, they are prone to leakage. So one advice, please don't use 0.45 Metcopo. You can use 0.45 step tie if your woodwork is very close. Let me show you some houses that have used 0.45 step ties to do. This one is 0.45 step tie. You can see you can see there is no much difference. Even somebody tell you that this one is 0.55, you accept because it's neat, because of the woodwork are very, very close. So this one is 0.45 step tight. Let me still find another how that I use 0.45 step ties to do. If I can see, I didn't gather most of the. Okay, this house too is 0.45 step ties. So this one was done in Benin. It's very neat too, just because of this, the camera snap it on the way. That is why it reflects like this. So there is ray of light. So this one too is 0.45 step ties. So the woodwork is, the plant spacing are very close and the wood is very, very high. So this is an example of 0.45 step ties. So let me still check if I can see some another 0.45 step ties that I did. So that is the one I can still remember for now, but you can use 0.45 step ties. But for Metcopo, don't even try that. Don't try using 0.45 Metcopo because it has disadvantage. It will still give you problem in future. And if you so we want to discuss about Metcopo now. So this is an example of Metcopo. This is a green Metcopo. This is a beige Metcopo. Beige color Metcopo. This is a Vanda Black Metcopo. This is a brown Metcopo. So Metcopo have 0.45 and 0.55, but don't use 0.45 for Metcopo. It's not good at all. Because of all these side like this, you can see this side like this, they are very, very prone to leakage. So meaning that, so this, if it is 0.45, all this curve will be solid, but 0.45 it will not be solid. So any small thing, if the lapping is too, if the lapping, if you lap them, because you know some people, you give them quotation, you may give them 500 square meter, another person now give them 480 square meter. The person that give them 500 square meter want to lap it very well so that there won't be any leakage, but to say the quotation you give me is too high. So that is how some people run away. But everybody wants to get a job, so we try to maintain ourselves. So it's better for you to do a very good work. Otherwise, a seller will just sell and install for you and go. If you leak, it will come back and redo it. You are the one that will be spending the money. So it's better you do a good work. So Metcopo, you make sure the woodwork are very close. I have discussed about the spoiling spacing of Metcopo. You make sure the woodwork are very close. Without so much people don't like a house that have too much design. So this is a red Metcopo. So let me now show you the house that have Metcopo on it. So this one is a Metcopo. You can see this is a Metcopo. Metcopo, a house that will flow easily without too much design. So Metcopo will go on it very well. So this one is called the fascia cover. So under here you have ceiling cladding. So this one is the ridge cap. This one is the sun hangu. So this one, some people will use sunbreaker here. This is the hangu. So this one is the ridge cap. So in between this space now, in between this roof and this one, there is valley gutter inside there before the roof is being laid. So this is an example of black Metcopo done in Benin. So this is another example of Metcopo. Let me show you another example of Metcopo. So this is a green Metcopo being installed. I'm not the one that installed this one, but the product is bought from me. So that is Metcopo. So this is a Metcopo. So this is a beige Metcopo going out from the factory. So anyone you are using, so some people will be asking what is the quality between this one. So this is a step tie 0.55 also installed. So some people will be asking this is another Metcopo. So this one, we didn't put Ivangu here because the person that owned this house want to use a water collector to surround it. You can see the house is not too high, but it flew, it come down straight, no too much design. to the design. So the design, there's no much to design. That's why it's very suitable like this. You can see the gutter have a design here. So that is, and this is sunbreaker. So that is met couple. So what you learn today is that do not use 0.45 for met couple. Don't even use. So if you want to use 0.45 for step ties, you must make sure your woodwork is high a little bit and the polar spacing are very close, so you can use 0.45 of step ties. But for long span, you can use anyone, so far you maintain your woodwork polar spacing, so anyone will go for long span, and anyone also can go for step ties. As soon as you want to use 0.45 step ties, you make sure your woodwork polar spacing are closer and the wood is high a little bit. But for met couple, don't even use 0.45 met couple. It will give you problem in future. So please, because of some people, to help some other people not to fall into mistake, share my video with them. Share my video, subscribe. Just if you are still watching my video and you see suspicion button is still red, please click on it, subscribe to it, share it with all your friends and abroad that are building, so that they will be able to guide themselves. So this is beige long span. All the products have 0.45, but there are some one that you don't need to use the 0.45. Run away from them. So anytime you want to buy aluminum product, you can call me anytime on 081-233-98890 or 081-649-4909-081-649-89907. That's my second number. Or you send, so we'll be waiting to hear from you as soon as you have finished your woodwork for supply and installation of any roofing product. Thank you very much for watching.